young lady. She actually is from here, and she's been living out in California doing her thing, and now she's back here visiting, so we thought we had her come up. Please help me welcome Melissa Eslinger.
I lost my voice, so if you find it, you can keep it, because I like being a 12-year-old boy. I do live in LA right now. I've lived there for 12 and a half parking tickets. It's kind of expensive. So right now I'm living in the backyard of a family of eight. They know I'm there. They have six kids. The youngest is two. She's potty trained just recently. And I came out of the bathroom recently. She was standing in the hallway with her bottle leaning against the wall. And she was like, "You go to the potty?" I was like, "Yeah." She was like, "Me too." Speaking of kids, when I was a kid, about 14 years old, I tried to kill myself, but I never finished anything. So, still here. Procrastination wins! Saved my life. I did it by swallowing a bottle of Prozac and an antidepressant, which was counterproductive. All I did was hurt my stomach. I was unable to cry for a week. I couldn't come. It just brought me right back to where I started. I thought I was a badass. I started cutting myself on the wrist, but I did it with push pins. Straight from my NSYNC poster. It's more like a tickle. The only thing that resulted from that was I wasn't allowed to pick out my own school supplies anymore. And my face on Office Depot. Do not sell sharp objects to this shop. Not that much of a consequence. I called a suicide hotline recently. I wasn't really going to kill myself. I just wanted to run some jokes. It's the perfect audience. You hang up on me, I hang up on life. You stay, you listen. You laugh. They put me on hold. That's when it happens. I had a hard week recently. All in 1 week, I lost my job, my car broke down, and my air mattress started leaking. I have a college degree, my bed leaks air. Nothing like a hard day getting home, just but hey, at least life let me down easy. I'm gonna go ahead, so thank you. I used to live here in Kentucky, and Facebook still makes fun of me for it. I was playing that game where you click a button and it's supposed to tell you who your soulmate is.